UFC 243, Brian Campbell, days away. The UFC middleweight title will be unified between the existing champion, Robert Whittaker, and your interim champion, Israel Adesanya. We talked a little bit about this last week, by the way. That clip, I don't know if you went back and watched the views. Did you see the views for that clip on last?
I did not.
It's the best clip we've ever put out in terms of views on our now burgeoning channel.
Wow,
right?
Wow.
People were interested in it, yep.
They're like, enough of these dong jokes. Let's get down to fight breakdowns.
Let's get down to some breakdowns. So here's the question for you. I'll actually pitch this one back to you if I can, because I've done not one, but two dissecteds on this, Brian Campbell.
Professor Salt and Pepper on fire.
All right. Well, you know, we didn't get to one last week, Jay. In any event, give me an X factor. Give me an X factor for either guy. What is something you're thinking about here for maybe either guy that you're not saying it necessarily will make the difference, but it could?
Well, I think for Whittaker, it's very obvious to point to the inactivity. 16 months here, coming off of multiple sort of injuries and setbacks. Can he be the same guy in what you can look on paper and arguably say this could go down as the toughest fight of his career? 2-10 rounds with Yoel Romero is as tough as you're going to find. We're going to find out on Saturday if this qualifies under that same regard. But to come back to this level of fight with that kind of time off is certainly very interesting. And I think without Adesanya, we don't know how great he can be. I think we kind of have a feeling how great Robert Whittaker could be. Robert Whittaker is a great-ass fighter. He's incredibly tough. He is so durable, carries out a nice game plan, does a lot of things well, Luke. But I think we figured out through 10 rounds with Romero, he's pretty damn great. Adesanya has that potential next-level ceiling here, and that is so intriguing to watch in this matchup. Can he do the same things to Whittaker that he has done to others? Who is going to get off first between these two and try to take the lead and make the other one be a counterpuncher? If it's Whittaker who does that, is Adesanya going to jump out and gain control of this fight by being the more dynamic, quicker-handed guy to come out here? There's so many sort of X's and O's things I'm interested in finding out, just as much as if both guys are dialed in and are just about even in terms of overall ability. We're going to have five hellacious rounds here because Adesanya just went through the hell's oven there against Gastelum and passed with flying colors. And he's fresher right now. I think suddenly Whittaker, who is the rightful favorite in my mind, has a little bit more to prove in this one.
When you say Adesanya is fresher, you mean because of the time off between the last fight and this one? Right, because he was just bouncing between camps essentially at that point. Yeah, I'll give you an X factor for both of them. You mentioned the time off. I'm actually going to say that cuts both ways. So on the one hand, with the time off for Whittaker, it's like, dude, you've had two fights in 26 months, and you're now 28 years old. That is a lot of time off. And I realize some of it's due to injury, the last-minute cancellation against Kelvin Gastelum. Who could have foreseen hernia or whatever the situation was? Is there going to be ring rust? The rule about ring rust is, Dominic Cruz says it doesn't exist. Well,
oh, it exists.
It exists. But the key is, it only exists on most fighters, most fights, most of the time. Not every fighter, every fight, all the time. So the question is, does he have some ring rust? Which intersects with the other part about that. Dude, when you go from 26 to 28, you're talking about the time any fighter's career, much less any elite champion, where they put together skills, camp over camp over camp. Case in point, Israel Adesanya, right? It's exactly what he was doing from 27, 28, 29. Okay, so my point being is as follows. It could be the case that he has no ring rust. It could be the case that he has some ring rust. And at the same time, he's got a whole new bag of tricks we haven't even seen before. All the tape we're looking on him from was from over a year ago. And before that, a year before that. So my whole point being is, when he comes out there, what setups is he going to have? What different takedowns is he going to have? All these different pieces of the puzzle, he's never shown anyone. There's no tape on. He could unleash that on Adesanya.
That's an optimistic way to look at it. And I get that.
I think it's somewhat, dude, you're talking about a...
But the biggest...
Hold on, last thing on this, and I'll let you go. We're not talking about any old donk. We're talking about Robert Whittaker.
Talking about Knuckles.
We're talking about
The
very best middleweight, while as we currently speak, in that division. I think it'd be very foolish to discount his creative potential.
I'll give you that, certainly. But when you're talking about ring rust, your biggest fear is timing. He would not need timing in any other fight in his career more than he would need it against Israel Adesanya. If this turns into a close-range chess match, a kickboxing match, then this is going to be a style of fight he could potentially lose if that timing is off.
But this is my point. If the idea is that he's going to show new wrinkles, again, one of the dissecteds is, what do we know about Whittaker's offensive wrestling? And the answer is, not much. But we do know, in his time off, he got good enough to wrestle at international freestyle tournaments. If you want to wrestle against anyone, it's the guy who's good at kickboxing, or I should say, who is great at kickboxing, who is good at wrestling. That's your peak moment and opportunity, and he's never really shown that. This is a chance to flip the script.
And to be fair, you know, he was a headhunter for most of his early rise at middleweight and really started to work in the leg kick kicks in the two Romero fights, and you'd have to think that's going to be a strategy that's going to be key against Adesanya.
Last thing about Adesanya, don't you agree with this? His coach, Eugene Behrman, brought this up. Why is there a consistent and pervasive doubt about him? Every one of his opponents, from Wilkinson to Vettori to Brunson to less so Tavares, although Tavares a little bit, but then you go back to Anderson Silva, I guess a little bit as well, and then Kelvin Gastelum certainly, they're all like, dude, he's not that good. And I'm like, well, no fighter is perfect, and he's got limits and they're identifiable, but newsflash, he's fucking awesome, actually. He's very good. Why can't they just say that?
Because anytime you're flashy and you're a trash talker, and you give the appearance like you might be somewhat one-sided, you're going to get haters who need to see and be critics first before they can be proven. I mean, he answered so many critics with the backbone he showed against Gastelum. We haven't seen anybody take him down and make him pay for it yet. And that could end up being a factor in this fight. Let's say Whitaker is not having the success on the feet. Let's say he's getting solved in that area. Will offensive wrestling be a big part of it?
I think it
will. It just seems like Adesanya is answering each question each time that he needs to. And let's not forget, Whitaker was also the underdog in like six of his last eight fights before winning the title. So it kind of happens to everybody until you consistently prove it on the elite level. But how about this, Luke? Gastelum fought the fight of his life against Adesanya, correct?
Up to that point.
Not just in terms of
up to
heart,
that. He's still young.
But
he's
game plan-wise?
Yeah, up to that point.
You go back and watch that fight. Gastelum had a set game plan and the angles and the ways that he attacked. Is he potentially more dynamic of a threat than Whitaker was? Whitaker's a better fighter than Gastelum, all well-rounded. And one thing the Reaper does is he will outlast you. He will grit and get through it. But is the game plan and the potential offense that he brings to the table really not as dynamic as what we just saw from Gastelum in the fight of his life?
I disagree. There is, to be sure, it was not that I was not sold on Kelvin Gastelum. I always knew he was good. But after the Adesanya fight, I looked at him and said, I have misjudged him. He is much better than I thought he is. Much, much better. I really came out of that fight thinking very highly of him. On the other hand, what makes Adesanya what he is? It is the level of advancement. So again, one of the things I did for Dissected is fainting. Fainting is, you know, in boxing, it's so common you almost take it for granted. I won't say it's absent in MMA, but it's not universal, and guys aren't nearly as good at it. Adesanya is incredible at it, and you take someone else who's also good at it is Robert Whittaker. There's a degree of technical advancement to Robert Whittaker where, is he the marauder that Kevin Gastelum is? Is he willing to put more offense together in quick spaces?
He's a little
spaces?
More meat and potatoes than Kelvin Gastelum.
I would actually say it's the opposite. I would actually say those blitzes that he has are perfectly timed, covers distance quickly, full of trickery. Who's got more trickery in their game, right? Who makes you look this way while they go that way? It's Robert Whittaker. Robert Whittaker does a lot more of that. But the question is, when you meet your match in someone who can do that, how does that play out? And I guess I just don't know the answer.
And I think when you look statistically, when you get real nerd heavy, Adesanya doesn't get hit a whole ton. Whitaker absorbs more punishment in these fights. You know, he went in there against Romero and fought in the dungeon for many of those rounds and came out on top.
I want to verify that, but go ahead.
How much if Adesanya is able to slip and counter and get consistent in that, will we see Whitaker have to go to a plan B that we've never seen before? Right. These are a lot of intriguing things. I know there's a lot of haters watching this going, Adesanya's not the real, he's going to get pummeled. I really like Adesanya's chances in this fight.
To me, it's like if you don't take either of them seriously, I don't know what they can do at this point.
Is it a legit 50-50 pick 'em?
Well, which way are you leaning, actually? Let's ask that.
I'm leaning Adesanya.
Is that right? Yeah.
I think he has more to show us that we haven't seen to go to an even higher level.
It's just, to me, it's like, what's better? All that time off and then developing a bunch of skills and then getting a chance to show it when there's been no tape on it? Or back to back to back to back to back with a quick break at the last interval and then bringing all that to bear? Which is a better way to get ready for this kind of a life challenge? I guess we're going to find out. I lean Adesanya too, but I've been an Adesanya homer, so I'm not reliable.
See, I haven't, and I've come around to such a... it's certainly so exciting to watch, but the idea of believing that we're seeing a truly special talent who's only getting better and only has even more in the tank and tricks to show us that we haven't seen.
I see.
I mean, seriously, sitting cage side for that fight against Gastelum, I mean, that was one of the better experiences as a journalist or a combat sports fan of all time, and it really opened my eyes to, we don't even know how great he can be, whereas Whitaker's damn great. Love him.
I'll give you something. Gastelum was more in Adesanya's face. I don't know that Whitaker will do that. Whitaker might give him a little bit of room.
Who's going to end up being the counter striker in the end?
Adesanya,
and that's where that's going to play into his hands
a little bit. Yeah. Also, if he waits too long with someone with the speed of Whitaker, it could be problems. To me, it's like You got two of the very best in their athletic primes. It's amazing.
Are you expecting an absolutely insane atmosphere there?
Oh.
I mean, this is an all-oceanic hard-on. This is amazing.